Good evening. I'd like to extend my greetings and best wishes to President Cortes and his team and to all of you, my friends in Paraguay. I'd like to congratulate Paraguay on its ranking as number 56 of the 133 countries covered in this year's Social Progress Index, the index of 2015. The Social Progress Index is a comprehensive framework for measuring the health of a society, whether society is progressing, whether citizens are having their needs met and have the foundations for improving the quality of their life, and whether opportunity is being created for all of the citizens. The Social Progress Index is now in its second year, and it is really defined the rigorous tool for benchmarking countries in terms of progress on society and societal issues. Why is this important? Well, I think what we know is that the success of a society is more than just economic. If a country is doing well economically, but its citizens are not having their needs met, they're not able to improve the quality of their lives, and there's no opportunity for citizens to advance, then actually economic success alone is not enough. And what we're starting to understand around the world is that actually if we want to achieve truly inclusive growth, we have to achieve both economic success and social success together. And not only is social success essential to translate the benefits of economic growth to the average citizen, but actually social success is critical to long-run economic success. Unless you have the conditions in a society for people to have a good quality of life and to improve that quality of life, then ultimately economic growth will not be robust and will not succeed. Paraguay has achieved a good performance on social progress based on the Social Progress Index. It's a country that has improved its social indicators in keeping with the improvement in its economy that it's enjoyed over the last some years under really this new leadership. Paraguay has a particular strength in opportunity we find among countries, in the inclusion and the ability of anybody in Paraguay or many citizens to achieve whatever they want to achieve and not be limited by discrimination or lack of rights or other barriers. But in Paraguay, as in every single other country, there is a long way to go to keep raising social progress even further, to raise the bar to an even more successful and inclusive society. And I know that the leaders in Paraguay, and President Cortes in particular, are really dedicated to this goal. I think in Paraguay, you have been among the leading countries in the world in formally, explicitly including measures of social progress as critical goals in the development process. And the 2030 National Development Plan makes social progress one of the cornerstones. And this ability to kind of integrate economic planning and social progress in the national development framework is something that is really quite unique among countries in the world. And I'd like to congratulate you, all of you, and congratulate President Cortes on this vision and also on the progress that's now being made to create a rigorous strategy, not only for economic growth, but also to really drive improvement in social progress. We are all around the world looking to Paraguay to continue its leadership in this area. We are looking to Paraguay to show that by setting clear goals in terms of social progress, this mobilizes even more commitment and more focus on improving social progress. And I think in this area, Paraguay is truly a model for the world. So congratulations, and I wish you great joy in celebrating this wonderful event.